It's crazy to think that once upon a time, Sunderland were a marquee name in the Premier League. Now fast forward to 2022, they're a marquee name in the third tier division of English football. After it being very highly requested since I began this rebuild series, we are finally taking a trip up north to rebuild Sunderland. Let me know in the comments down below who you want me to rebuild next. As you can see, I'm open to any and all teams. Just give me a little bit of time to do them because I can't do them all at once. And if you want to enjoy today's video, be sure to leave a like, smash that subscribe button, it really does help with the growth of the channel. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have yet to see one of my rebuild videos before, here are the rules. The main objective of this rebuild is to win the Champions League. I can make any transfers that I want, making it as realistic as possible. All games have to be simulated, but the Champions League final has to be played. Now that you know how this works, strap yourselves in and enjoy the video. Beginning our journey with Sunderland, we start with just over 3.2 million. Now for this rebuild, I was going to start by sending a scout out, focusing more on the youth academy, and then I stumbled upon Matthew Kemp, who's 17 years old and is already 77 rated. He is by a mile the best player in Sunderland right now, so you better believe he's getting straight into that starting 11. Our first bit of business in this transfer window was bringing in Yalcun Kayan for just over 2.3 million to bolster to that midfield. And that wraps up that transfer window. We only did a couple of things in that window, but I think that the things that we did do were vitally important towards season one success. Now, I'm not too sure whether straight away I want to get promoted, because obviously the Championship is an absolute bitch of a league to get out of. I think before we can contemplate promotion to the Championship, we definitely need to strengthen the team a hell of a lot more. But I've got a lot of hope and faith put into Kemp. He's 77 rated, 17 years old already. He's definitely going to be a vital part of our journey in the first 5 years at least. So we have just gone to the halfway point of the season. We are in the top half of the table. We're currently sitting in seventh spot, but there's not much difference between seventh spot and fourth spot, so there's not much to worry about, to be fair. There's less than 3 points in it, so I'm not at all worried going into the second half of this season. Probably one of the best bits of business I've done in quite some time, this is Josh Onomar. We have brought him over from Fulham for just over £2 million. We are continuing to strengthen our team, and that brings that transfer window to an end. This is how the team's looking. It's massively improved from the beginning of season one, I think. Kemp has gone up to 80 rated. In order to progress, we may have to sell Kemp in the next couple of seasons, because the money that we could get for him, we could spread across the team and massively bolster the strength of it entirely. So far though, season one's gone pretty well. I just hope by the end of this season we don't let ourselves down. Well, we fell off massively. Jesus Christ, I didn't expect that. I thought we would have got top four at least, but we did end up finishing eighth in the first season. I mean, maybe it's a blessing in disguise, because we're nowhere near ready for the Championship if we're finishing eighth in the league. Definitely need to strengthen the team a hell of a lot more. Meanwhile, Manchester City won the FA Cup, Liverpool won the Carabao Cup, Accrington Stanley won the Papa John's Trophy, Spurs won the Europa Conference League, AC Milan won the Europa League, and PSG were crowned champions of Europe. I think within the next two seasons, we're definitely going to have to cash in on Matthew Kemp in order to bolster the squad. If we can keep him for another couple of seasons and he goes up by five each season, hypothetically, we could easily get 200 odd million for him, and you could spread that across the entire starting 11. We would be absolutely incredible. I do think though, with the right signings next season, we're definitely looking at promotion. To start season two, we've been given just over 6 million. And beginning our transfer period, we have brought in Amadou Dante for just over 2 million. We've just picked up a right-headed Njemi, Arat Calderon, 18 years old, and we've just picked him up on a free. We've just picked up another player on a free. This time it's a goalkeeper, which we desperately did need. Rafa Prodo, 18 years old, 67 rated. We brought in yet another free agent, this time in a guy called Daniel Cordozzi. He's 16 and already 70 rated. So I'm pretty sure we've just picked up a goldmine of a player. And that wraps up that transfer window. This is how the team is currently looking. I've changed the formation to a 4-3-3 flat. I think that's the best way to approach this season with the team that we've got. I mean, I feel like that complements them a lot more than the 4-2-3-1. We may give Kemp a couple of more seasons and then say goodbye to him, cash in on him, and then spread that money across the team. I think that's probably the most smart thing that we could do. But I am hoping for a much more successful season this time. This time, I'm looking to get promoted. We are doing much better this time. We are in the top four. It is looking looking good. There's only 3 points separating ourselves from top spot. I'm very confident going into the second half of the season with the signings that I have in mind. The first one being the Ukrainian Talarov we have just brought in for just over 2.3 million just to bolster the defence. And we found this guy on a free, Severo Cancio, 19 years old. He's 68 rated already, so I might give him a chance. I'm not too sure yet. We'll see. And that wraps up that transfer window. This is the team. This is how it's looking. And to be honest, I reckon we got promotion in the bag this time. It's a very well-rounded team. This keeper, I've got a very good feeling about this keeper. He's gone up 3 already this season. He's only 18. 6'5" as well. He's a bloody giant. Yep, I think we got one for the future in this, man. Definitely need a new right back to begin season 3 with, though. But other than that, I'm exceptionally happy with how this team is looking. It's official. We are into the championship for season 3. And we have taken our first stride of many in getting Sunderland back to where they belong at the top flight of football. To be fair, we absolutely stormed it. We were 7 points clear of MK Dons, 10 points clear of third place. I mean, to be fair, we absolutely ran riot this season. Meanwhile, it was Newcastle United who were the FA Cup winners this time. Everton beat Chelsea in the Carabao Cup final as well. We ended up winning the Papa John's trophy this time, so that's another trophy to add to the collection. Villarreal won the Europa Conference League. Napoli won the Europa League. And it was PSG who were crowned champions of Europe once again. Kemp has improved 10 overall in the past 2 seasons. Like, but this man is a machine. He also got 41 goal contributions and 56 appearances. That is monstrous stats. Ross Stewart as well, he did absolutely brilliant, to be fair. 23 goals, 1 assist. Winchester had a surprisingly good season as well. 7 goals, 6 assists from the right back position. Fair play to him. I have to admit, this guy I've got a lot of hope for. He's 17 years old, 73 rated already as well. This season's anything to go on. Maybe cause Dozer is the future of Sunderland. But this time, we're in a much tougher league, so season 3's transfer windows are going to be vital that we get them right. In season 3, we've been given just over 13 million. And we have started our transfer period in season 3 by making the biggest signing we've made yet in Arnau Martinez for just over 6 million, a much needed upgrade in the right back position. We have made yet another massive signing that can contribute towards our success this season. Tyrese Dolan, 75 rated, 6 million on the dot. We bought him over from Blackburn Rovers. We've made yet another free agent signing this time. I'm pretty sure we picked up Nemanja Matic's regen. Nemanja Tomić, 21 years old, 73 rated. I know that he's 5'7", but I am almost certain this is Matic's regen. Plus, it gives us a lot more squad depth in that midfield role, and it does say he's showing great potential, so it's a win-win either way. And that is the end of that transfer window. We are done and dusted, and this is how the team is looking. I've changed the formation to a 4-3-3 defensive formation because we've got 2 CDMs, and I tried to put them on developmental. It took so long, so I thought this would probably be the easier option to do. But that midfield 3, I aren't going to lie, I've got a feeling that they're going to be the future of this Sunderland team. If we can build it around them, I'm going to be very happy. The only thing we could really do is get another centre-back. Now, this guy, he's been with us since the start, Doyle has, 19 years old. I've given him quite a bit of chances, to be fair. I'm going to continue to do so for the time being, but if we can get someone better, I'm going to take that opportunity. Unfortunately, Prado is injured, but I think we will have him back for the next couple of weeks. I'm not too sure, but I am really happy with how this team is looking. We've got quite a bit of squad depth as well. We've got Onomar, Kayan, Roberts, Cancio. We've got a very, very good team going into this season. Honestly, I'm expecting promotion once again. Just a quick one before we skip to the halfway point. We did manage to sell Josh Onomar for 3 million on the dot. This happened directly after I just updated you guys on the team. Now, let's skip to the halfway point. So, at the halfway point, we are absolutely killing it. We're 4 points clear at the top of the table. Hopefully, we can keep this form going for the remainder of this season and we will once again be in the Premier League. We've done our first bit of business in the second transfer window by selling the guy that we brought very early on in this rebuild, Kayan, for just over 2.5 million. He's been a fantastic servant for the club, but it was time to let him go. We have also just sold Luke O'Neill for just under 2 million. And that wraps up that transfer window with the team looking like this. I mean, to be fair, there's not many weak points in the team now. We could do with another centre-back to get rid of Doyle. I mean, we'll not get rid of him. Doyle could go onto the subs bench, but we definitely do need a stronger centre-back going into the next season, if we do get promotion at least. I must admit, I was hoping for a little bit more improvement between our middle three, but there's still the remainder of the season to go for that. I'm very surprised nobody came in for Kemp. He's 19, 89 rated, but the thing is, I know for a fact, the money that we're going to get for Kemp, this team will have a makeover and a half. With the amount of money we'd get for Kemp, we'd win the Champions League within 2 seasons of selling him. But we have to get into the Championship first, so let's see if we got there. So, we ended up choking automatic promotion. Bournemouth and Brentford are into the Premier League. It is ourselves, Swansea, Nottingham Forest and Stoke City who are in the playoffs. Now, the moment of truth. Are we back in the Prem? Come on! We are back into the Premier League. Season 4, Sunderland, the Black Cats are back into the Premier League. Meanwhile, it was Everton who won the FA Cup. Manchester City wiped the floor with Wolves to win the Carabao Cup. It was Everton who won the Europa Conference League. Juve won the Europa League. And it was Liverpool this time who were crowned champions of Europe. I'm really happy with how the team's doing, in fairness. I mean, this guy was a mistake, to be fair. I don't know why I bought him. But I'm actually quite confident that we can go into the Premier League and it not be a case of fighting for survival. We could be pushing maybe a top 10 finish in the first season, providing we get the decent budget that we deserve for getting promoted and we can get the right signings in. Either way, season 4 is going to be quite an interesting season. In season 4, we've been given just over 50 million. And our first signing is a guy called Imran Loser, 25 years old. He cost us just over 30 million. He's going to slot straight into that starting 11. And that is the end of that transfer window. This is how the team is looking going into season 4. And I'm not going to lie, yes, there are definitely weak points in this team. We brought in Loser, who is definitely strengthened midfield, but I could do a Calderon and Tomic to vastly increase in overall by the end of this season. Otherwise, next season, we're going to be looking at replacements for quite a few people in season 5. Stewart's really surprised me. He's gone up to 79 rated, 28 years old. I was initially going to sell him in this period, but I think I want to keep hold of him because he's done exceptionally well for us since the beginning of this rebuild. But as for my expectations for how I want us to do this season, I'm not going to lie to you, I have no idea. I just don't want to go back down. As long as we don't go back down, I'm not bothered. Not going to lie, I'm very happy with how we're doing so far. We're just under mid-table, we're 12th in the league, and to be fair, considering we've only just been promoted, we're doing an absolutely outstanding job. We bolted the defence a little bit with this, and we've just brought in the Italian Emerson away from Chelsea for just over 11 million. And that concludes that transfer window. This is the team, this is what we are currently working with, and I'm not going to lie, it's vastly improved since the start of this season. It's looking a lot more like a very established Premier League side now. I want Prado to keep growing, keep improving. I want another centre-back, ideally. I'd like another CDM as well, because Tomic, he's definitely been improving. Calderon, on the other hand, he's really been static this season. Other than that, I'm very happy with how this team is looking. I just hope that by the end of this season, we are still a Premier League side. So we have come to the end of the first season in the Premier League with Sunderland, and we have stayed in the Premier League. We've survived. We are only a couple of points behind top 10 finish. So overall, I would say that this season was a massive success. Meanwhile, Liverpool ended up winning the FA Cup. Man City ended up winning the Carabao Cup. Stade Rennais won the Europa Conference League. Barcelona won the Europa League. And it was Atletico Madrid this time who were crowned champions of Europe. I've made a decision about Stewart. I'm going to keep him for as long as I possibly can whilst it makes sense, because this guy has constantly been in the top 3 goal scorers season after season. I know he's a striker, but just because you're a striker in career mode does not mean that you're going to find the back of the net. This guy has consistently done this season in, season out, and I want to keep him. Tyrese Dolan's beginning to come good now. 83 rated at 23. He's going to be a very good player in the future. Matthew Kemp, say no more really. But next season, I think we do need to make a couple of pretty big signings to start pushing ourselves higher in the league. In season 5, we've been given just over £40 million. We begin our season by bringing in a brand new centre-back by the name of Mark Guy. We brought him in from Arsenal for £25 million. We do love a free transfer on this channel. We have picked up Weston McKennie. Why anybody would let this guy go on a free, I'll never understand. But one man's trash is another man's treasure. And that is the end of that transfer window. And it was a very successful transfer window, if you ask me. We brought in Mark Guy, brought in Weston McKennie on a free. I mean, you can't ask ask for much more than that. We have changed the formation up to a 4-3-3 holding just so we can fit the midfield three in properly without having to mess with developmental or anything like that. I'm hoping for an improvement on last season. I don't want to go backwards. I don't want to stay the same. I want to improve on where we finished last season. So I'm hoping maybe a top eight finish. I'd like Europe, but I can't see it happening realistically. It would be amazing if we could get Europe. Now this is looking pretty promising if you ask me. We're currently 7th in the league. We're top 8. So as it stands, we have got Europe next season. I just kind of hope for the remainder of this season we can keep this form going, because like Europe next season would massively help us with the budget that we've got. We've just done a massive bit of business. We brought in David De Gea for just over £8 million from Manchester United. I have a feeling that for the next two seasons that we've got this man, he's going to massively help our team out. And that is the end of that transfer window. We've got David De Gea between the sticks in goal. This team is looking relatively decent. I just hope that we can keep this form going into the second half of this season. And hopefully, with any luck, by the end of this season, we will have gained entry to European football. Guys, we've gained entry to European football for next season. I'm absolutely buzzing with this. I think it's the Europa Conference League that we will be entering next season. It's us and Everton because it's top eight or whatever it is. But yes, no matter what, we are in Europe next season. Meanwhile, Liverpool won the FA Cup. They also won the Carabao Cup. AC Milan won the Europa Conference League. Man City won the Europa League. And it was Real Madrid who were crowned champions of Europe this time. You know, out of all the players this season, it's Kemp who's had a shocker. Oh my God, he only scored 9 goals out of 40 appearances this time. To be fair, considering the stats, how we finish 7th, I will never know. I think one thing we definitely need to do next year is bolster our defence though. Like, I think our defence is definitely the weakest part of the team. Once we brush up on that, we'll stand a good chance of being successful in Europe. In season 6, we've got just over £50 million. Now, to kickstart this season's transfer window off, we have brought in Shalobah from Chelsea. Now, this guy, I really wanted to get last season, but I just couldn't afford him no matter what I did. This time, I made a point of buying him first. We bolstered the defence even more by bringing in Kyle Walker-Peters from PSG for just under £28 million. And that wraps up that transfer window, and I'm so happy with how this team looks. Look at how good this team has become over the past couple of seasons. There's literally no weak points now. All of the players are over 81 rated. They're all good in their respective positions. I think we're going to do well in Europe this year. I think we're going to do well overall, to be honest. We've definitely got the squad to do well this season. We are in Group E in the Europa Conference League. We're joined by Dynamo Zagreb, Wolfsburg AC and Strom Godset IF. Now, I'm not being funny. If we don't wipe the floor with that goddamn group, there is something just amiss. As predicted, we did dominate Group E. We only lost 1 out of 6 games, so that speaks for itself, really. We are currently in the top 6 in the Premier League. Now, if we win the Conference League, it doesn't matter where we finish in the Premier League. We're still in the Europa League next year. But really, I'm gunning for that top 4 spot. That's where I want to be. We did nothing in that transfer period. We were very inactive. I may live to regret that decision, to be fair. But at the same time, I'm confident in the team. I'm confident that we can progress. I'm confident that we can get Europe once again next season and do quite well in the Europa Conference League. We unfortunately dropped off a little bit. We didn't make top 4. We did still make top 8. So regardless, next season, we are still in Europe. It's a little disappointing, but it does mean that we still have stuff to improve in the team. Meanwhile, Liverpool won the FA Cup. We ended up winning the Carabao Cup, beating Everton 4-3 on penalty. So it's not all doom and gloom. We also went on to win the Europa Conference League, beating Wolfsburg in the final. So that means we're in the Europa League next season, which also should mean a much better budget to work with. Roma won the Europa League, and it was Manchester City who were crowned champions of Europe. I have to say, these three, just, they're phenomenal. They are absolutely phenomenal. Ross Stewart has 85 rated, got up 3 this season, he's 30 years old. This guy, honestly, if you ever want a lower league budget striker to go for, get Ross Stewart. He has been sensational. To be fair, looking at how we've done this season, we've definitely had a very, very positive season. We've definitely improved from last season. Even though we finished one place below where we did last season, we've still definitely improved. Won the Carabao Cup, won the Europa Conference League. We are now in the Europa League next season, so hopefully the budget is a much better budget to work with next season. In season 7 we've been given just over 60 million. And to begin things off in this transfer window, we have brought in Alejandro Grimaldo for 30 million on the dot. Now, I looked at the starting 11 that we currently got, and there's only one area that really needed working, and that was the left-back position. I decided to bolster the midfield a little bit more and bring in Ismael Benacar for 43.5 million. And that is the end of that transfer window. This is the team. This is an updated look on how the team is going into this season, into the Europa League. I'm quite confident to say, I reckon we've got a good shot of winning it, to be fair, with this team. It's ridiculously well-rounded. There's only a couple of spots, ideally, that do need improving if we are successful in winning the Europa League or getting a top four position by the end of this season. No matter what, though, I want to get Champions League football for next season. I feel like the team is good enough for Champions League. We are in Group E, joined by Club Brugge, Hajduk Split and Bromby IF. Again, if we don't win this group quite easily, there's something wrong because our team is ridiculously strong. We absolutely stormed it. We didn't lose a single game. We only conceded 2 from 6 games. That is pretty monstrous form, if you ask me. We are once again in the top 6 at the midway point of the season. I'd really love to get that top 4 spot, man, but we're 5 points beyond it. The thing is, though, there's still a second half of the season to go, so it is possible, but we do need to be on rock solid form to get there. We once again didn't make any signings or sales in the second transfer window, purely because there was none that came in that interested me. There was not that. I can't believe that there's been absolutely no transfer offers for Matthew Kemp since the beginning of this rebuild. The guy is 23 years old, 96 rated. He's got to be the highest rated player in this career mode anyway, and nobody's even attempted to come in for him. I reckon we've got the Europa League in the bag, man. Honestly, I reckon the front three are low. I can't believe Ross Stewart's 87 rated. I did not see that coming when I began this rebuild. But nevertheless, we've got Europa League, we've got the Premier League. Let's hope by the end of it, we've won the Europa League and we've got a top four position in the Prem. So in the Prem, we unfortunately didn't make it to the top four. We got top six, to be fair. We were 5 points off Champions League football for next season. Ugh, I'm gutted, man. I'm really gutted about this. I don't really know what we have to do to get Champions League football. The team's definitely strong enough to do it. It's just they can't do it on the pitch. Meanwhile, Liverpool won the FA Cup. Chelsea won the Carabao Cup. Lazio won the Europa Conference League. Okay, so we are in the Champions League after all. We beat Roma 3-2 to win the Europa League. Next season just got a hell of a lot more interesting. And PSG were once again crowned champions of Europe. Like I said this time last season, if you are looking for a very good budget striker to begin a lower league team rebuild with, get Ross Stewart. Look at this man. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm thinking of putting Matthew Kemp up for sale just to see if anyone will come up for him, because at this point, he's got to be worth at least 250 million. I think that's what makes the most sense anyway, especially now that we're going to be in the Champions League. Speaking of, our budget should be over 100 million next season. If it's not, I'm not going to be impressed. If it's over 100 million, I can put a guarantee that we will get to at least the semi-finals next season in the Champions League. In season 8, we've been given just over 90 million. I can't believe they haven't given us 100 million at least. The stingy bastards. And we start this transfer window off by bringing in a brand new keeper by the name of Luis Maximiano. Cost us 30 million to get. The reason why we brought in Maximiano is because David De Gea is steadily declining in overall, and we definitely need a better keeper because now we're in the Champions League. Not only that, we brought in a brand new right back by the name of Hugo Sique. It's 5'9". He cost us just over 44.5 million pounds to rob away from Real Madrid. We definitely needed a new right back. This is exactly why you need to check your free agents at the start of every single season you do on Career Mode. We have just picked up Joao Polinha for free. 32 years old, granted, but he's 87 rated. This man is going to be so crucial to our chances in winning the Champions League this season. I don't know why it won't let me show you on the transfer history, but we have also picked up Christoph Baumgartner on a free as well. We've just sold David De Gea for 34.4 million, and we only bought him for, I believe it was 7 million. That's what you call profit. I cannot believe how lucky we have just been. We have just got Leon Goretzka on a free. Manchester City, we're approaching him as well, and we got there just in time. If we don't win the Champions League with this team that we have just built, I do not know what else will. And that does wrap up probably the best transfer window I've ever had, and probably the luckiest as well. This is how the team is looking, and I'm confident in saying that I reckon we've got this Champions League in the bag. Not only is our starting 11 incredible, our subs bench is absolutely stacked as well, just in case any of our players decide to get suspended or injured. Let's go to the group stage to see who we're up against. We're up against Juventus, Galatasaray and Spartak Moscow. We're up against Juve, Spartak Moscow and Galatasaray. Now, I'm not too sure how Juve's team is looking at the minute, but it's Juve, so we're going to assume it's very, very good. Galatasaray and Spartak Moscow are definitely the weaker links out of the four teams. So, realistically and logically speaking, we should be looking at ourselves and Juve going through. I hope so anyway. I do not want to crash out of the Champions League the first season we enter it in only the group stage. That was certainly a lot closer than I anticipated. It was Juve and ourselves making it through to the round of 16 as I predicted, but I didn't think it would take that long to do it. You know what I mean? Not that long, but it definitely was more difficult than it needed to be. Now, the question is, who's our round of 16 opponent? We are up against Borussia Dortmund once again in the round of 16. Okay, we're making a habit of banging into these guys in the round of 16 lately. Okay, Bournemouth are fucking top. What? How? Bournemouth are top of the league by four. Bloody hell fire. Okay, this season's a wacky one. This season is a wacky one. We didn't do anything again in that transfer window because we're broke, to be honest. And nobody, again, nobody came in for Kemp. Nobody came in for any one of my players. I don't understand why. Like, I'm not knocking it, don't get me wrong. But it is official now. This is the team. This is the squad we are going to be taking into the second half of the season to attack the Champions League, and to see if in the first season we are in the Champions League, we can be crowned champions of Europe. But we have to get through Dortmund first. Now, Dortmund normally have a semi-average team at this point in the game, but this time, they've done their own work. They've definitely upgraded their team. Look at that team, man. They've still got Haaland, they've got Camavinga, they've got Ndombele, they've got Timber, Koble, Frimpong. Very good players all around. This, it could go either way. We're at the Stadium of Light in the first leg. Let's see if the Black Cats can bring it home. Ooh, okay, it's 1-1. They don't have Haaland in the next game, though. That is brilliant. That is brilliant. Hopefully, we can take full advantage of that. I have to admit, it's nice for once to go into a knockout stage of the Champions League and not have a suspension on our side. Instead, it's the opponent's side. Haaland is out with the suspension, as you guys can remember, because it was literally just 2 seconds ago for you guys. They have got another striker in his place, Madueke, or however the hell you pronounce that name. I'm hoping that we can pull this out of the bag because I don't want to do another season. Come on, thank you. I've been sat in this seat all day rebuilding Sunderland. This is the goddamn season. I spoke far too soon, didn't I? We've got Dolan out with a suspension for the first leg against probably one of the best teams. Actually, looking at that team, it's not actually that good. I mean, they've definitely got some talent in there, but if you take a proper look at the team, it's not. They've got Laporte, Livramento, he's definitely going to be good now. They've got Vinny, Kubo, Kovacic, but really, there's nothing really too scary about that team. We're at the Stadium of Light in the first leg. Hopefully, Dolan being out isn't too bad. Okay, this is exactly what I meant about Madrid's team. And you actually look at it, not that strong at all. We're 2-0 up going into the second leg. This should just be a formality now. I'm not going to big this up at all. We've done the hard work in the first leg, so I'm relatively confident going into this game that we can just finish it off. Literally, we are at the Bernabeu in the second leg. Let's just take your turn and get into the semis. There we go. 2-1 win. Stewart. I love that. He's my new favourite player. He is in the Rebuild Hall of Fame, Stewart is. I swear to God. Sunderland fans, you should be proud. Now, this is going to be a tricky game. Liverpool have done this right. Liverpool have bought for the future. Look at that team. Look at that front three. They've got Diaz, Jota, and Antony. Antony, as we all know, is freaking ridiculous if you use him properly. Their middle three, Bellingham, Tchouaméni, Guendouzi, all ridiculous players at this point. Garcia, Tapsoba, they've definitely done their own work and they know exactly what they've been doing. This is probably going to be a very, very close tie, but we are at the Stadium of Light in the first leg. Let's hope we can contain the Scousers. We beat them. We beat them 2-1. We've got the advantage going into the second leg. We are one win away from being in the final. The fact that we're one win away from the final fills me with so much joy. My arse is so numb from sitting down all day. Oh shit, I've just noticed Pellini. Actually, to be fair, that wouldn't be too bad because the amount of backup we've got this time, there's no way I can see us losing this. There's no way I can see us giving this up. We are in the final. Prove me right. Yes, come on. We make it 1-1, 3-2-1 aggregate. We are into the Champions League final. This season is the season we do it. It is PSG versus Sunderland in the Champions League final this year. Now, before we get into all of that, let's check how we've done elsewhere this season. We've had our best Premier League finish yet. We were 1 point away from becoming Champions of England. Oh my, we were literally 1 point away. We have better goal difference than them. 1 point, you jammy shit, Chelsea. I'll say this though, Bournemouth fell off, didn't they? Holy shit. 11 points between them and Chelsea. That it must suck for Bournemouth, but at least they've got Europe this time. Meanwhile, it was Fulham who beat Chelsea in the FA Cup final to be crowned FA Cup winners this time round. It was us who won the Carabao Cup this time round as well. A little bit more silverware to add to the collection. Nice won the Europa Conference League and Wolfsburg won the Europa League. PSG's team is ridiculously all over the place, isn't it? They've got Højbjerg and Mbappe, Dest out of position, Marquinhos, Donnarumma, Hakimi. But other than that, I'm not too familiar with their team, to be fair. But I'm not going to take that for granted. When you look at PSG's team, I'm fancying my chances. It is PSG versus Sunderland at Sanderson Park in the Champions League final. Let's get into it. PSG versus Sunderland in the Champions League final. That is definitely a sentence I never thought I'd say. Right, okay. Stewart's amazing for us, but I think it's going to have to be Kemp who's going to run the show today. Kemp is... Oh, he's still got the ball. Oh, Marquinhos is an absolute demon at the centre-back position, isn't he? PSG are just absolutely destroying us at the minute. They are destroying us, and this is not even close to being funny. Oh my god, Grimaldo with the block. Oh my god, I've just given it straight back to him. We're asking to concede here. Oh my god. Mark Gee. Jesus Christ, what a tackle. It's our turn now. Can we get it to Dolan? Dolan against Morelli. Can we find Stewart? Oh, can we find anybody? Oh shit, that's a cracking ball. Oh, what a tackle from Mark Gee. Is he going to find... Stewart is through. Oh my god. Stewart from season one. Two now has been constantly one of the best players we have got in this team. The most consistent goal scorer we've got in this team. And he's just bagged one for himself in the Champions League final. First time, first touch, bang, get in. Clinical as you like. Top goal scorer for us multiple times throughout this rebuild. I'm not surprised I was able to get one with him. Oh no. Mbappe's through. Oh my god. Mark Gee is... hands down saving our arses in this game so far. Honestly, he's made so many good tackles in this game so far. And that is the halftime whistle. We go into the halftime break 1-0 to the good, courtesy of a strike from Ross Stewart. Ain't gonna lie, we don't deserve to be winning. PSG have dominated the majority of the game. However, we are in the lead. Dolan, we're going to cut this inside. We're going to find Stewart. Stewart's going to find Goretzka. Oh my God. The counter-attack of absolute dreams. Man that we picked up on a free this year, somehow, I don't know how, manages to bag one for himself in the Champions League final with an absolute rocket of a left-footed shot straight top right bins. Well, not top right, but you get what I mean. 2-0 to the good. PSG are going to have to do something quite drastic to get back into this game. Otherwise, it's game over. Oh no 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 no. Oh my god. Oh bloody hell, literally I jinxed myself. I said they had to do something drastic and they've just turned into prime Barcelona. No matter what I did then, I could not get that ball away from him. Like, that had never happened in real life. Just, oh, come on, man. That's such a sloppy goal to give away. It is a very good job we scored two goals. Otherwise, this next half hour could be very tricky. Kinney, can we find Dolan? We have found Dolan. Can he use his pace? Can he use his pace? Can he use everything he's got? Oh, my God. I can't believe... What a bad defending that was from PSG's defender. Oh my god, Chalobah has just done Mbappe like a kipper there. Can we find... Oh my god, Goretzka's away. Now we've got two choices here. Do we go to the corner like a noob or do we go for goal? We go for goal. We have Goretzka and we make it 3-1. Game, set and match. Sticky near post strike, back of the net. Donnarumma don't stand a chance there. PSG lost. It's game over. What? Oh, come off it. How many times did I tackle him then? It really doesn't make all that much of a difference anyway. There's no way in hell that they're going to score now. And that literally was the last kick of the game. The Black Cats, Sunderland, have risen from the ashes and have been crowned champions of Europe, courtesy of a strike from Stewart and two goals from Leon Goretzka. Let me know in the comment section down below what team you want me to rebuild next. I'm open to any and all teams. Just give me time to do them and I promise they will get done. If you have enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like on the video. I have been sat here for so long, I can't even remember when I started. If you are new around here as well, be sure to subscribe for more videos just like this. It massively helps with the growth of the channel. It's been your boy Goodwin, and until next time, I'll see you later.